Hello YouTube fam, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Tina and I make videos on lifestyle, home, and DIY projects every single week. And for today's video, I thought it'd be fun to do some Thanksgiving DIYs. And I don't know if people are actually doing anything for Thanksgiving. I feel like all I'm seeing is just Christmas stuff everywhere. I still wanted to create something for Thanksgiving because it's one of my favorite holidays. It's when my family gets together and we eat so much food. But regardless, each one of these DIYs works so perfectly for fall or harvest themed decor. So you can definitely customize these, and a lot of them I just created with things I already had in my stash. So I didn't really spend much money on any of these at all, and I really love how each one of the projects came out. So without further ado, let's go into the first project. Hello from VoiceOver Tina. For this first project, we're going to create some really cute place cards starting with some metal wire. I actually already had this one from Dollar Tree for a while, so I'm just going to cut it and create a small ring with it. And then all I'm going to do is to wrap it with some raffia to create the base of our wreath. Alternatively, you can use some wired wine, so you could skip this step completely. But for this project, I just used what I already had at home, so I'm wrapping it around the wire and gluing it with some hot glue every inch or so. You'll notice that one part of it is going to be a bit more bulky, and that's totally fine because it'll actually give us more room to work with when we're gluing down our florals. I ended up wrapping it around twice to really make sure that the wire didn't peek through. So here's how our ring is looking so far. I then went into my DIY stash to see what I could use for this project. So I used some dried eucalyptus, which is actually from the bouquet Brian got me. And I let the leaves dry out, so I thought it would be perfect. And then I used a bunny tail because I have so much of it, so of course I had to use some. And then I also used these cute little whitewashed pine cones from Dollar Tree. The first thing that I laid down was actually some more raffia, and one thing you can do with it is actually to split it apart, so this gives it a lot more texture. And lately I've been making so many wreaths on my channel, so you guys already know the drill. I always go for an asymmetric look. So you can see I'm first laying down things that are a little bit more linear, like these leaves, and this really just helps you move your eye around the wreath, especially since it's more minimal. It's really great to kind of just have it spread out. It's always so fun to play around with the placement of everything, and these materials are really great because each piece is so unique since these are organic materials. With the eucalyptus, I'm able to pick it apart and just choose the placement for each leaf and seeded bunch. Then I'm going to add in my bunny tail, which again helps you draw your eye outwards from the center point. And for the focal piece, I thought that these pine cones would be a great alternative to flowers. I was actually inspired by a Fabulous Fet on Instagram for this project, and I will link the original post down below. She used dried flowers in her wreath, but feel free to use whatever you have or whatever fits your holiday theme best. Alright, so I'm loving how this is looking so far, and you could totally stop here if you just want to make some mini wreaths for decoration, or even do this project in a larger scale as a full-size wreath for the holidays. But these are going to be place cards, so for the names, I'm going to use some scrap water paper color that I already used to test out some previous projects. And the first thing I'm going to do is to create a torn deckled edge, and I'm just going to use my ruler as a guide to rip the paper towards me. And as you can see, it creates this beautiful raw edge that I love so much. And then I'm just going to gauge how big I want my place card to be and just cut it with some scissors. Then I'm using my Crayola Super Tip markers to write the name onto the watercolor paper. And I'm going to create a faux calligraphy look. So to create some thin upstrokes, I'm just using the tip. And then I'm going to use the edge of the marker to create my wider downstrokes. You can totally leave it like this, but of course I had to do the faux watercolor trick, and if you've been on my channel for a while, you're probably familiar with this hack. All I'm going to do is to dip my fine tip brush into some water and just trace it over the marker. Doing this magically makes it look like you wrote it in watercolor. It's one of the easiest things to do, and it just allows you to have more control writing with a marker rather than using a traditional technique with a brush and watercolor. And if you can't already tell, I absolutely love the way that this looks, and if you haven't tried it yet, I would definitely recommend that you do. Now you can pop your place card into your wreath. You can totally glue it in, but I'm choosing not to just so that I can reuse these later on. If you want to add a little something special to your table this season, this is totally the way to do it. Not only is it super cute, it also serves as a little decoration that your guests can keep forever. You can also turn these into ornaments, and I think that would look so cute on a tree. I was able to create these for free with things I already had, and there are so many ways that you can style them for the holidays. So I absolutely love the way they came out, and I hope that you guys try this project out too. For the second project, I'm using this plastic gourd that I actually got in a set of pumpkins from IKEA. I had no idea what to do with it, so when I saw this project idea on a house that Lars built, I knew that I just had to use this for Thanksgiving. First off, I'm taking a piece of scrap cardboard and I'm going to create a dome shape, and that's going to be about the same size as the gourd, and I'm just going to cut that out with my scissors. Next, we're going to create the tail feathers of the turkey. So I'm just going to use some dried wheat in this really cute pink color. Feel free to use any dried plants or florals that you would like. I think that regular wheat would also be great, or even bunny tail would look super cute. Before I glue anything down, I'm just going to roughly lay it down just to give myself an idea of the height and the placement. Then to glue it, I'm adding a line of hot glue, and I'm just going to press the stem right into that glue. Now I'm going to repeat this step and create a half sunburst shape with these wheat pieces. And to create a more organic look, I'm just going to keep these staggered. You could totally make these all the same height if you want, but it's all up to your own preference. So after I glue down my first layer, I'm just going to add in a few more pieces in between the initial layer, and I'm going to make those a lot shorter. This is just going to give it a lot more dimension and fill in the empty spaces. Alright, so this is looking pretty good, but I'm going to hide some of that cardboard coming through. So I'm going to cover it with some of the extra pieces of wheat. And as you can see, I'm just going to break the pieces of the stem into smaller pieces and then just glue that right on top. This part is totally optional, but I wanted to take this extra step just in case. Moving on to the gourd, to give it a bit of an upgrade, I'm going to add some gold leaf to the stem. And the stem kind of represents the turkey's beak, and I think this is going to add in a nice pop of gold. It's going to be so perfect for this project. As you can see in this clip, initially I used some hot glue just because it was right next to me, but then you'll see that I'm going to use some Mod Podge to ensure that I get it covered completely, and I would totally recommend that route rather than using the hot glue. Now that everything's dry, I'm gluing the gourd to the wheat feathers, and when I'm doing this, I'm gonna make sure that the piece is stable enough to stand on its own. So it kind of takes some finessing to get it right, but I'm just gonna let it glue down completely before moving on to the next step. The last thing I'm gonna do is to add in some more wheat right at the bottom in between the gourd and the feathers, and this is really gonna fill it up and complete the project. And now your new little turkey is ready to be displayed. This turkey totally looks like something that Anthropologie would have on display at their store. It almost looks like a peacock, and I absolutely love how the pink looks with the gold. And again, I made this for free with stuff I already had at home, and I think it came out so cute. You can make a whole bunch of these to create a beautiful tablescape, and I think this is such a fun and creative way to DIY some non-traditional decor. And I hope this inspires you to think outside of the box to create your own decor too. Those were all the projects for today's video. They were all so easy to make, but also super cute. And I think my favorite definitely has to be the wreath place cards. I just really love creating place cards and making guests feel special. And if you're looking for more place card ideas, I will actually link one of my older videos down below. And in that video, I actually create 4 different place cards, and I really love each one of those as well. So if you're interested, I will have that link down below. Also, before I forget, I wanted to announce the winner from the giveaway in the last video. I'll put their comment on the screen, and I've already contacted them, so their gift card is coming soon. And don't worry guys, if you didn't win this time, there will definitely be another giveaway coming soon, and that giveaway will be really fun, so I'm super excited for that. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe down below for new videos every single week. And also follow me on Instagram, I'm posting on there every single day. I also wanted to share a few of the DIYs that you guys have been tagging me in. I absolutely love seeing all the recreations that you guys send me, and they just warm my heart so much. So thank you so much for sharing with me. It just brightens my day so much. All right, so that's it for today's video. I'm super excited to work on more DIY videos for you guys. I'm really looking forward to just decorating my place for the holidays, and I just can't wait. So be sure to stay tuned for more projects. Thank you guys all so much for watching. Stay inspired, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!